Hello, hello. Okay, I think I'm live. I think. This is my first time doing this, so I could be wrong. I'm gonna get on Instagram live as well. Let's see. Yup. Okay. Okay. I think we're on. Are we on? I think we're on. Okay. Oh, hello. Hi, everyone. Since we're waiting for everyone to show up, I'm just gonna drink just a little bit. I can't hear y'all. This is gonna be a little awkward at first. But hey, I can read what you write. Oh my God, you're my fave. You're my fave too, Hannah Kay. Oh, hello, Alexis. Hey, Kaylin. Hi, everyone. Okay, first off, let's just go ahead and start drinking. Already uncorked this little sweet baby. Just trying to break the ice, awkward ice. Nobody here to show. I'm used to the applause, but today our wine glass is sponsored by my 7-year-old niece that said she saw this and it reminded her of me, so she bought it for me. And let's just say I wasn't disappointed. Okay. One of the best wine glasses I've ever received. But what's the name of that guy on YouTube or not on YouTube, is it BuzzFeed? That he gets really sloshed and then he talks about like what things are the worst. I wanna be that. I don't wanna just sing, I wanna, you know, just be a raver. That would be nice. Just wait for everyone to show up. Hello, everyone. Hello, please let me know that y'all have got a drink. Let me know whenever you get your drink filled up. Oh, thanks, Susie. My eye makeup. I look like I'm drunk already. I'm not yet, but by the end of this, I should be, so. Can you sing a song? Yes, I can. Just give me a little while longer. Everyone's showing up. Hello, Corey, over there on Facebook. Hello, Mary. I've got chocolate milk. Sosie, that's good. That's good. Sosie, y'all don't know her yet, but she just commented on there. She is actually playing a little red-headed girl in a music video that we just did. So you will see very much a lot of Sosie in a little bit. But okay. Do I pee in pools? Yes, of course I do. Next question. I'm kidding, I'm kidding. It's a joke. If you were at Crash My Playa, you would know that the joke right before I left, I saw Lauren Elena in the airport and told her where we were going. And she told me the one thing I had to do, there's a stage that is in the middle of this giant pool. And she said, the one thing you have to do is you have to ask how many people have peed in the pool today. And so I did. And then this dude came up with a hat that said I pee in pools. And I put it on. So I wonder if anyone has like video of me on stage with a hat that says I peed in the pool. But if they do, I guess it's good memorabilia. Okay, I think it's time. I've given y'all 3 minutes to pull in here. I am live on Facebook. So right before we start, over here. Trying to make this a moment, okay? But I'm gonna use my Las Vegas lighter I got with one of my best friends, Emily. And I'm going to use this beautiful candle. I'm not used to the reverse. But Saint Dolly, we have to light her candle before we start. I'm shaking. I don't know why I've been so nervous today for this. And also, my friend Emily gave me these really crazy candles. Sorry, Instagram, if you can't see this, it's on Facebook Live. The screen for some reason is a wee bit whiter. Wider, not whiter. But, anyways. All right, I probably should have cut these wicks. Doesn't matter. They'll burn down anyway. Okay. How many people have come in and how many people have got out? Hello, okay. I'll try not to be nervous, KR0044. This first song, if you see me looking off, it's because I do have guitar chords. I'll be honest, I don't play guitar on a lot of stuff these days. I'm normally wiggling around on stage. So today I'm going to play you a couple of my own songs. I went through this morning and last night, and I looked through everything that y'all told me when I wrote y'all's response or whatever. I can't talk. When I put that little sticker out, I'm not good with technology, so give me a second. But a lot of y'all on Instagram responded with what songs you wanted to hear. So I have a couple for a few of you, and I mean, I'll be honest, most of these, they're just like, they're songs I really love, and I hope that everyone is staying safe in the quarantine and having as good of a time as you can. Oh, I'm sorry, little babe. I just like slapped my hands down in an aggressive way, and she's like, that was my nose. I'm sorry. Say hello to everyone. This is a little beanie baby I own. A stinky breath beanie baby, but really great one other than that. Okay, I'm seriously about to start, I swear. But I just wanted to explain because I know that this is a weird group of songs, and I know that. But I just wanted to sing a couple songs that I never get to really sing. I want to play y'all some stuff that is not even on this record. It may be on the next one, or you know, it may just never come out, so this may be the only time you get to hear it. But I really wanted to play some stuff that's kind of out of the blue, and hopefully liven up your afternoon. And I'm just going to pretend like this is kind of a jam to myself, so if I'm zoning out, closing my eyes, or messing up, just keep drinking. The more you drink, the more fun all of this is. So, anyways, yeah, I guess we'll start. Beanie, are you good getting on the ground? Yeah? Okay. Okay, goodbye. You can sit over there. Alright. So, we got the news this weekend, the awful news, that Kenny Rogers had passed away. And, man, I used to listen to this song nonstop when I was a kid, but I used to think that the second line of the chorus was 400 children. Oh, can y'all see it? I'm just making sure. Someone said the Facebook Live isn't working. But I used to think that the second line was 400 children and a crop in the field. So it's not. That's what I figured out in adulthood. But either way, misheard lyrics or not, this is one of my absolute favorite Kenny Rogers songs. So if you know it, sing it with me. And if you don't, weird educate ya. Okay? So let's do this. Thank you.
kept coming back time after time. You picked a fine time to leave me loose, you. Four hungry children in a cropping field. I've had some sad times, lived through some bad times, and this time.
R.I.P. Kenny Rogers. If you have a drink at your house, I'm not condoning drinking, just I enjoy it. If y'all do, let's put our glasses up to Kenny Rogers. Thank you so much for the music you made for us, buddy. We will really miss you. That is one person I've always wanted to meet, was Kenny Rogers, but one day, on the other side. Alrighty, what do y'all want to hear next? Hi, thank you so much, Sass Girl, I really appreciate it. I'm just going to go ahead and jump to the next one because it's really hard to read all the comments, though I love it, so please write me comments or else I'll start feeling like I'm not doing good enough and then be really sad, so write me comments. Unreleased things. Okay, Alexa. Okay. I want to throw one out here. If you're okay with the original, I would love to play an original for y'all. Hello from the UK. Hello. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. Okay. So this song, the whole reason why I did this song, why I wrote this song, was I was a recently new signee at Universal Publishing. And I had a day that I was supposed to write with this this writer that was really good. I won't name names, but anyways, it just turned out that they had to cancel. And they didn't cancel until I was legitimately at the place. And okay. People are sending a request to be in my live video. Don't know what that is. If someone wants to explain that in the comments. I'm technology deprived. That's not the word for it. Oh, they said I'm getting really distracted. This is why I can't do this. But so that when that person canceled the write and I was already at the publishing house, I was like, dude, I put makeup on. Like I put pants on. I did the things today and I'm not going to let this just, I'm seriously not going to, I'm sorry, I'm reading so many things. Oh my god, okay, I will add y'all right after this song, I promise. But anyways, I was just like, man, I gotta make this day pay off. So what I did was I just decided to write by myself, and I just found these two little chord movements that I really liked.
I don't know it now.
Oh, I'm in the wrong. You hopefully I looked funny. Also, I just went into a meeting earlier that week with this outside writer that would mentor young writers, and I brought a bunch of songs in, and I really loved these songs, and I felt like they were really vulnerable and very much me. And they told me that women do not want to be perceived as desperate. He said, no woman wants to hear a sad song about herself. No one. And I think that's 100% inaccurate. And I like that a dude told me that girls don't like to be seen as desperate. No one does. But the thing is, heartbreak does something to you, man. And somewhere between the heartbreaking and getting over things, I've done crazy stuff. I've cried over crazy things. And anyways, this is... I love that bullshit is what we call that. Sorry, maybe I shouldn't cuss on here. But as the line goes, I might. But what I'm saying is, yes, it is Vacancy Light is the song I'm going to sing. This song is seriously just me being as desperate as I wanted to be. Also, I say the F word in this song, which... I'm not going to, just because if kids are watching, I don't want to ruin it for them. Okay. Anyways, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm really awkward now. It's different when I'm on stage. I'm concise. When I'm here, I just talk. So here you go. This is Vacancy Light. Also, all my songs are a lot slower, so just get ready to jam. Just lay on your bed. Put some light, some Christmas lights on, turn off all the other lights, get a glass of a really cheap Chardonnay that makes you remember the college years, and just, no, James, this is not on the record. Maybe on one, though. You were humble, and I was homesick. You were perfect. And I messed it up. You were a phone call that I shouldn't have made, but I was lonely. You were perfect. Now there's cigarette burns in the motel curtains, spots of light on the unmade bed. I hear the neighbors fighting, and I miss you, damn, I miss you. I'm just sprawled on the floor like.
Damn, I miss you. I'm just rolled on the floor like a rag doll.
another drink. Thank you so much, Brenda Tomlin. Lance, my guitarist, get off here. I'm not playing any Smash Mouth, though I wanted to. Just because you asked for it. What am I saying? Okay, so I have a dry erase board that I need to throw away. And thank God I didn't, and I'm naturally a hoarder, because now things have come in handy since quarantine has cut my shopping. So I have a dry erase board with all of my songs on it. And right now, I want to ask y'all, do you want... I was about to say fast or slow, but like, I'm all in mid-tempo. So, please play Just Friends. I can play the beginning, but every time I've ever played it by myself completely, it just doesn't sound right. We need the drums. We need to have the little xylophone, but I can play... Okay, play a cover. Oh, thank God. I got a lot of covers, not as many originals ready, just because I play my originals a lot, and I will play originals for y'all, I promise. But I just wanted to play some songs that really do mean something to me. So, you know what? Let's just go to David Allen Co. Little story while I pour another glass of wine right here. The stories are better than the songs, so just get ready. I was working at Tootsie's, and I was working on the main stage, which is the front room, and if you're playing the front room and you are a female, you are standing on the bar 90% of the time. The girls have to dance on the bar. And anyways, so I was up there singing and dancing, you know, doing what I had to pay my bills, and anyways, this guy came in, this older man came in, and he said, "What kind of old country do you know?" And I said, "Well, someone told me to drink from the bottle. I'll do whatever y'all want." What does that say about me? But anyways, this guy came in, and when he had old country, I was like, "I can play anything you want." Our drumsticks used to play with Lynn Anderson. Bass player used to play with Patsy. You tell us what you want, and I will play it. And anyways, he asked for "Stand By Your Man" in the key of A. And anyways, it was really funny. I love that song, and the man that I actually got to know through that old man, his name was Gary Gentry, and he wrote one of my favorite songs of all time, weird and coincidentally. He wrote the song, the Corvette song by George Jones, which I wish I had learned on guitar now, but anyways, he's really known for his biggest hit was The Ride by David Allen Co. And I am actually going to sing Stand By Your Man and The Ride today, so y'all tell me which one y'all want first. But anyways, you know, it's one of those things that's really cool when you get to meet people that got high with Johnny and drunk with Patsy. You know, you get to meet people that really had these, like, crazy moments of sincerity and just... fun candidness with these artists and these musicians that I have just loved so much. And when I met Gary and we started writing and became friends, this song, he said he had just a spiritual moment with it, so I want to play this and send it out to Gary Gentry. I'll play Stand By Your Man in just a second, I promise. Now listen, no one can hear you, okay? Because I haven't accepted the live thing yet because I'm a little afraid of it. But what I'm saying, the good side is, no one can hear you. Sing as loud as you flippin' want. This is the one place where you can be free. You can be butt naked. I don't care what you're doing on the other side of this camera. Just enjoy yourself, okay? All right. Carson, my younger cousin just wrote, she gonna be drunk before this is over. Yeah, Carson, you're in a family, you know how this works. Come on. Okay, all right. I actually wrote just the beginning chords because I always have to have the first few chords to know the song. Okay. do this. You ready to sing? Are you ready to sing? I'm waiting for y'all to answer me back. Okay. I was thumbing through Montgomery, had my guitar on my back, when a stranger pulled up beside me in an antique Cadillac. He was dressed like a 1950, half drunk and hollow eyed. He said, "It's a long walk to Nashville, would you like a ride?" Sat down in the front seat, he turned on the radio, and them sad old songs coming out of them speakers was solid country gold. And I noticed a stranger with ghost white pale when I asked him for a light, and I knew there was something strange about this ride. He said, "Son, can you make ghosts cry when you play and sing? Can you mow and goose? Can you bend them guitar strings?" I said, "Son, can you make folks feel what you feel inside? 'Cause if you're big star bound, let me warn you, it's a long, hard ride." I cried just south of Memphis. Cried just south of Nashville. Turn this car around. He said, "Now this is where you get off, boy, 'cause I'm headed back to Alabama." As I stepped down on the Cadillac, I turned and I said, "Mister, many thanks." He said, "You don't have to call me Mister, Mister. The whole world calls me Hank. Mister, can you make folks cry?" Thank you, Nate Smith. I appreciate it. Chances of me twerking to Kaylee? You better twerk. Yeah! My free concert in a long time. Yeah, Rolf. We're desperate to connect with people, even if it's for free through the interweb. Lance, my guitarist, said, "I'll chug a beer for every verse or chorus of All Star you sing." Okay. All right. I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to stand by your man. I'm going to get really serious. I'm going to do all the things. But if I can look up All Star by Smash Mouth, I'm looking it up, sorry. And I can get... Wait, are there chords? Okay. Okay, wait. Okay, Lance Flippin' Heron. All right, you better try. Hi, Trey. You better get in here because I'm gonna put you on live. Come on, Lance. Come on. The people are waiting on you. They're not waiting on me. They're waiting on you, Lance. Lance. Hey. Okay. All right, let's see. Facebook. I hope that y'all are still there. Some people are... Okay, guys. All right, here's Lance Herring. Okay, so you said you will chug a beer for every verse I play of All Star by Smash Mouth?
I only have so many beers left, so you have to be kind.
How many beers you got, buddy? How many beers?
Jesus. I got these.
All right, get them ready. I'm expecting you to chug. Everyone's expecting it, too. We're expecting you to chug on camera as I'm playing, okay? I can't really watch you. I'll have to watch you later because I got to look at the words, all right?
I promise I'll do it.
Okay, you ready? Let's go. Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kinda dumb with a finger in the thumb and the shape of a nail on her forehead. Well, she did stop coming and they don't stop coming. Back to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense, not to live for fun. Brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see, so what's wrong with taking the back streets? Never know if you don't go. Never shine if you don't go. Okay, chug it now!
I did, you missed it.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. I don't know how to play that chord. You're a rock star. I gotta push it up just a little bit. I'm sorry. What? All right, you ready? Okay, I'm just gonna jump to the next verse because I'm pretty good at those.
Okay.
It's a cool place, but they say it gets colder. Bundled up, now wait till you get colder. But the media man says to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. Warm's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey! Hey now, you're an all-star. Put the game on, go play. Hey now. You're a rock star, get the show on, get paid, and all that glitters is gold. Only shooting stars break the mold. What'd you say?
I should have never made this bet.
Yeah, how's it going?
I don't chug beer.
I don't chug wine, I'll do it with you. Alright, everyone on Facebook Live, I don't which one's more fun. I'm guesstimating Instagram. Facebook, you get a little bit more of a wide peripheral view, but over here, there's Lance chugging beer. Didn't you have one more you had to chug, dude?
No.
He did two.
I did two.
Holy wow, you did two in that time? Does it seem like it? Yeah. That was really nice.
Okay. Go try not to die.
Okay, try not to die, and I'll see you later, bro. Bye. Okay, so since we're live on the wrong Facebook, well, so let's just keep going. Yeah, if you can't find me on the internet, just find me on the other run. I'm really bad at this. Okay. Hello, Irene. Hi. So now that we've got one person drunk, I'm waiting for the next person that will chug to a certain song. And anyways, I'm going to play this song, which is a little difficult for me on guitar, so I may be looking at verse chords again. But this song came out, I believe, in 1968. It was a song that supposedly was written within 15 minutes. Between the artist and the producer. I am speaking about Tammy Wynette and Billy Shirley, and they came up with this masterpiece and did not even realize that, this song was going to be her biggest hit. They thought that D-I-V-O-R-C-E would be her biggest hit, and then this song just came out and bam! So I love singing this song, and I hope that y'all like it too. This one goes out to my publisher, Cindy Foreman, okay? Bye. I'm like a little concerned about the Facebook not working right, but I'm trying, guys. Wow, I'm just not good at technology, and I really apologize for that. I am just an analog girl through and through. But anyways, okay. All right.
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man. And you'll have bad times, and he'll have good times, doing things that you don't understand. And if you love him, oh, be proud of him, 'cause after all, he's just a man. Stand by your man, give him to something warm to come to when nights are cold and lonely. Stand by your man and tell the world you love him. Keep giving all the love you.
Okay, everyone's kind of jumping in. Zach on Facebook. Hey, Zach, what up? I haven't seen you in forever, dude. I don't know Little Miss Lonely by Helen Shapiro, but I definitely will learn it. Also, if there's anything I want to hear, please DM me or message me or comment me. And I'm planning on doing this about early. So I don't know why I'm doing this. Maybe I shouldn't have drank that glass of wine. But just tell me, because I have nothing to do until tour starts. So, all right, let's just see. Let's just see what people are coming in. Okay, let's just see. Okay, all right, I'm picking you, Alexis. We're bringing you in. These are some of my my girls I love. Let's see if they're coming. Are they coming? I clicked on them. I don't know if they... Okay. I did, Carmichael. Well, I thought I did. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, instead of adding anyone, I'm just going to play the next song because I'm getting nervous that y'all don't like me anymore and I have to keep playing music. We've done The Ride. We've done Vacancy Lot and Seal. Okay, so we're getting a little farther down on the set list, and this is a song that I think would be... Dude, I don't know. I think it would be really funny. So I'm just going to go ahead and do it because I was in London for that one night before we had to cancel our flipping London tour, unfortunately, just so that we could get back before a travel ban was put in place. But anyways, this song, the reason I want to play it is someone asked me in an interview while I was in London what my favorite song was that I've ever written. What song makes me laugh or makes me happy? And I was like, okay. Probably out of all of them, my favorite one is Knocked Up. I have a song called Knocked Up, and it's based on some true events that me and my co-writer had went through, and it's all about being a young woman in today's world, where when you have a breakup and you might have got a little frisky with someone, you worry the whole time until, God tells you you aren't going to have a baby. And anyways, this song is about that. I think it's the most risque song I have, but also I think the goofiest song I have, but in the best way. I wrote this song with Connie Harrington. It has become one of my favorites to just kind of have in my back pocket, and you cannot hear this song anywhere else. This is the only time I've ever played it for video taking, whatever this is. So I'm gonna play y'all a song, this song, while I tune. I kind of thought this song would sit in my back pocket for my entire life and no one would ever hear it. It would just be like a funny one for me to go like, oh, remember that time you wrote that song about, like, you know, going to buy a pregnancy test? And it sticks around, so... Connie Harrington, if you're there, I'm playing our music. I hope you like it. But the reason I'm playing this is, again, my publisher, Cindy Foreman, said I had to do this song. And after talking in an interview in London, I was like, you know what? Maybe I do. So here I am. All right. I hope y'all enjoy this, ladies. In so many cars, same. It happens to the best of us, man. It happens to the best of us. Thank y'all. Yeah, that's a really random one, but I really like it. I'll play it anyway. Okay, I would love to play on one that I have never got to play before, and I have to have the chords for it. I'm sorry. But I'm inspired by all types of music, and one type of music that I really love that, to me, it's what gets me through hard times is a lot of big band jazz music. I just love that old-timey soul that seems to be in all of that music. But I'll play Small Town, I promise. But this song, Nat King Cole, is one of the favorites of mine. And I may mess this one up, but you know what? Y'all are my captive audience, and if I mess up, you can leave. So it's fine. It's fine. On my 26th birthday, a couple days ago, I sat by myself and got drunk in my house because I turned 26 in quarantine. And anyways, this is a song that for some reason, at like 2 a.m., I sat against the bottom of my kitchen counters, the kitchen cabinets, and I played this song to me and my dog, and it made me feel so good. So I hope y'all like this. Sorry, I messed up that one a little bit. But you know, gotta practice somewhere. I guess that's the time to do this. But anyways, you make me smile too. I'll see what song we'll do next. really know. So I'm going to do a little Gloria Gaynor. If you've been to any of my shows, you know I love Gloria Gaynor. This song is the whole reason why I ever did music. My dad peer pressured me into playing the song or singing the song to karaoke track when I was a kid. And anyways, yeah, this is I Will Survive. My nails out too long. First, I was afraid, I was petrified. I kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong. And I learned how to get along, and so you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you with that same look on your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave the key. Sabidium orchid that I talk about in my Instagram stories. I have a love song with her. Well, not a love song yet. I gotta write it still, but whatever, you know. Can we have an outfit of the day? Yeah, this is a shirt that a friend of mine that was a country artist in the 90s gave me. Danny. Shout out to Danny. This is a comfortable jacket. And these are my sweatpants. That's the outfit of the day. Okay. Okay, actually, I have something to play, y'all. So MG91 asked for me to play, she asked me to play songs that got me my record deal. And there was two songs that I played. I had to meet with majority of the major labels in town, and I met with Universal first. And turned out that I played two songs in the room and Mike Dungan offered for me in the meeting, which I didn't know that happened. So it kind of threw me for a loop, to be honest. But anyway, the song, this is how this song was originally written. It's much more like, I don't know what the term is for this. Not honky tonky, but like boom, 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 boom. Yeah, Looking for a Lighter had a very different feel until I brought it to Gordy Sampson and Hillary Lindsay to finish the song with me. And I absolutely love where it is now, but I cannot play. I can't play what Gordy does because he's so good. So this is Looking for a Lighter the way that I had originally came up with the idea and had written it. So here you go. I played this and Small Town Hypocrite in my meeting with Universal that got me my record deal. So MG91, this one goes out to you. Wait, what? I had to write down all my capos because I can't remember where each capo goes for each song. Okay. Today I turn 23, finally catching up my own fake eye. Live video ended on Instagram and it really threw me for a loop, everybody. I apologize. I've never done these, so I don't know that they're just an hour long, but I guess I will come back with more. I will bring many more next time. So if you want to come back next time, I will play more of my music. I know I'm ending very dramatically and sudden, but my streams aren't working, nor was my British accent. So, lovely, lovely. I'll figure out technology at some point. At some point, I'll figure it out. I swear. Maybe next time. Next week. Look for Tuesday next week, 5 p.m. Be back. And tell me what songs you want to hear. Okay. I'm not talking to us. Bye-bye.